And that's the basis you propose to build on.
That's
all
good.
Right. Let the little recession in business and take us back to 1942 and three times. That's pretty good time. Well, now that, I'd just be a little bit hard to pay at them prices to pay for a building put up at today's prices.
Sell your farm now and you'll have enough money to pay all your
taxes. Yeah, you'll pay it off and take most of it, take most of it in income. You know, there's some people that if they can get the front seat in the buggy, they'll get right in and go for anything.
I
like the front seat buggy ride.
Your statement
that's
there.
That's the thing that that started this whole thing down there.
Mr.
Lillard, you know, has proposed this program and tried to get the city of Winterset to build him a building.
Pick up
and they didn't. They didn't do that.
Would
so
you be in favor of this if it didn't cost anymore? This consolidation.
He wants us to. He wants us to build it now. The rural area, and it's not a very square setup.
Just please be seated now. I've got another word to say. I didn't get to talk very long in my first speech, not near as long as you've been talking. Because
I don't know. I can't believe you did, according to my...
They only allowed me 4 minutes, 3.5 to be
exact. Let's talk about the school.
That's why I want to make a little more of a talk.
Okay.
I'd like to mention the teacher situation. I said that Kenneth Speerah has a good teacher out there in his school. And I think he has a good school. But maybe 3 or 4 years from now, that same teacher will not be available. And he'll have to take the run of the mill. And it won't be so good. And you won't have the school that you think you have now as one of the best in the county. You may have a very mediocre school. And you won't be so proud to send your children down there. I met Mr. Speerah the other day, or rather stopped him on the road to tell him how foolish he was to take the negative of this proposition when he has to haul his children, which he says he's so proud to do.
Amen.
He has to haul them 1.5 miles to the schoolhouse and then go and get them again when he could, when he's right on the paving where
well,
the school bus
business.
Can go right by him down the town.
Mr. Holland, I'm not just talking about my child. I'm talking about her child that lives 15 to 20 miles from town. That's the little child that's going to get the raw deal, and that's the one I'm fighting
that
for.
That won't hurt that little child at all. My children walk to school for 1.5 miles through snow and mud and everything.
Yes, Mr. Holland, I'm going to cite you as an example. You went to the rural schools of Madison County, and you're today one of the best farmers considered in Madison County. Your brother also went to the little public school. Today, he's assistant cashier of the bank, the biggest bank in Madison County. You had 4 children. One of them is a teacher in the Madison or Winterset school. One of them is an instructor here at Ames. One's a graduate veterinarian. Looks to me like the little rural school did all right for the Holland family.
Amen.
Thank you.
Maybe it was the Holland.
What's going to happen for
could have been both
teachers? They can go to summer school, and after a certain length of time, then they can teach in town. I'm afraid we're going to lose all our country teachers. We have only one miss in Madison County now. The rest are all married women.
That is our problem, I admit. Don't let anybody kid you that the big consolidated school in town doesn't have a teacher problem. Let me cite a few examples. I did a while ago, I believe, to Mrs. Casper about the little girl or the girls coming over from the high school assisting the teachers in supervision in our present Winterset school. Did you ever look at the Des Moines Register back in the Help Wanted column around the 1st of September and see a whole column of high schools, consolidated schools, junior colleges, advertising for teachers? Don't let me kid you, they don't have their problem. At the present, today, in the Winterset schools, there's about 40 teachers. 9 of them only have a certificate or have an education of 2 years in college. That is a requirement for a country school out here where we are in the mud. They aren't a whole lot better off than we are.
How many country teachers in Madison County have 2 years education or more?
And I think you concede that those that the Winterset school or larger schools get first choice of what teachers to bribe.
Possibly.
I'd like to differ with Ralph here about the time. Ralph says it isn't the right time. Well, it never was the right time to do anything. As far as that goes, it never was the right time. Back in 1943, it had still been too high. If we were going to do anything now,
We can't wait on the time. We've got our children right now. If we didn't have them, we could probably wait. We've got them.
That's right, Ed. You've got a good point.
That's right.
We've got to do something. Wait a minute, Ralph. The time is right to do something. I think we should put our shoulders to the wheel, the town and the country.
And hang a millstone on the next two or three generations' neck, I suppose.
No, sir.
That's what'll do.
Put our shoulders to the wheel and do something to equalize this thing so that we'll all pay our fair share and give the children an equal opportunity in education.
Talking about a fair share, the rural area to pay that, the town area to pay that. Fair share?
That's what they call a fair share.
I meant fair share.
That's the thing that we want.
That'll have to be solved. Under the present plan, they have no suggestion to solve that.
Before we go into this consolidation, it's not time to consolidate, but it's time to get our shoulders to the wheel and get this other thing equalized so that we can go on and reorganize or do something to bring this other thing about.
I'd like to add to what Mr. Wilson says. We built the hospital over here in Winterset at a time when a lot of prominent men in Madison County went around the square telling everybody, don't vote for this bond issue. This is too high a time to build. We can't afford to build a hospital now. Everything is too high. But we went ahead and we voted the bond issue. We subscribed sums of money. And there wasn't anybody running around snooping into whether the town people were paying less or the country people were paying more. We all put our shoulders to the wheel, like Ed Wilson said, and we put that project across as a community project, and we're proud of it. We don't care whether the town people paid more or the country people paid more. We all did what we could.
Neither do I care.
That's all right.
We're still paying more. We're paying $1.5 million.
That's all right. We're still shouldering our responsibility. We're paying just a little more. Look at the difference in the prorated capital. It takes in the whole county's in on that. And there's a lot of people that donated to that. Are you going to donate $5,000 to the new building up there, maybe $10,000?
There's a lot of people donated to that hospital. If there's a campaign to donate, I think I'll take part in it. I always have done what I considered my share. Now, in regard to these figures up here, they don't mean a thing. I don't know who compiled them, but the chances are that they don't represent the fact.
They're the truth.
Well, that's what you say.
I can prove it.
Isn't there a limit to how much money can be spent in buildings?
I want to say a word for Winterset. They have gone ahead every year and taxed themselves. At the present time, they're taxing themselves 48 mils on the dollar. That's more than any of the rest of you are paying. And they're doing it not only to furnish a school for themselves, but to furnish a school for the country children that are coming in there to take
it. They're not furnishing us anything. Our per capita that they're sending in there now is $240 for every one of theirs.
That's true. We're paying tuition, but if we didn't have the Winterset school to send our children to, where would you send them? Would the Maxburg do, or Patterson, or someplace else
around? We've got wonderful rural schools and could have them if we would just spend a little money on them, like my school happened to do. I wasn't on the board. The board did a mighty good job, and I'll give them credit for it. And every other school where there's enough pupils to operate a school could do the very same thing.
Amen. You are a privileged class in your district.
We've got good schools. You are the underdog.
Do you want to tear down our good school system, all of us, for the sake of one? No. I want to build you up if I can. I'll be glad to help you.
I just want to bring about an equality, and this would do it.
There's an easier way to do it.
Wouldn't do it. Perhaps in the dollar and cent value, but it would in the equality of opportunity.
Town's been talking, hadn't it?
Opportunity for the children.
The whole town's been talking. And now it's time to vote. The whole town's been talking. Now it's time for the whole town to vote. And I want to show you how to do it. This is democracy in action. It's a symbol that ought to go across this state. You got to talk and you got to think and then you got to do something. On your desk, you have a little. A button there, a couple of little buttons. Some of you can only see one, it's true. but put your finger on it and hold your hand over it and you'll have a secret vote. Now, quickly, this is the issue as you face it. Stay put. You don't believe in the consolidated system that Winterset proposes to bring the school under one system of 12 grades and to have equal representation and equal taxation, which would probably cost you a little more money. You agree. But now we want to vote, and you have 15 seconds to vote, and I'll tell you here when to start. Now hold the button down so we can count the